This is the first video in this series of science in glaucoma. Schwalbe's line is the starting landmark when doing gonioscopy. In this photo of a model, this is the location of the Schwalbe's line. Behind it, you have the trabecular meshwork, then the scleral pair. Here you have the ciliary recess and iris. We all know that aqueous passes through the trabecular meshwork to reach to the canal phlegm. So you need to start by identifying the Schwalbe's line so you can see whether the trabecular meshwork is visible or not. So this is the starting point. Here, this is the cornea. Section in a cornea on a slit lamp, you're going to see inner and outer surface and in between translucent tissue. On the other hand, back here in the area of the trabecular meshwork and the scleral zone, you're going to see only inner surface. This is the location of the Schwalbe's line between the cornea with inner and outer surface and translucent in between, and sclera, which is opaque. This is the extent of the Schwalbe's line. Actually, this model is not accurate. It should be like that. We all know that the cornea wedge is inserted into the opaque sclera. So in reality, you are going to see this area translucent, this area opaque. If you follow to the inner surface, this is the location of the Schwalbe's line. I put the model on a slit lamp. You can see in the upper part section in the cornea with inner and outer surface, while in the lower part only inner surface. This is the trabecular meshwork. It's opaque. And this is the location of the Schwalbe's line. This is the starting point. In a patient, this is the way it's going to look. This is the wedge shape of the cornea. If you follow this wedge, this is the location of the Schwalbe's line. You have to identify it by a section. This point here, where there is translucent in between anteriorly and opaque posteriorly. Once you see this, you can identify the rest of angle structures. Thank you for your attention.